So the reaction furnace is where the thermal combustion reaction takes place. It's a free flame reaction inside the refractory lined vessel. This is also where the majority of the overall conversion of H2S to sulfur occurs. And that's anywhere from 50 to 75% of that initial conversion. There are many side reactions creating unwanted products like CO, H2, COS, and CS2. For sufficient flame stability, a minimum temperature of 900 degrees Celsius is needed. However, temperatures above 1050 are desired for adequate destruction of contaminants like BTEX, mercaptans, ammonia, cyanide, methanol, and hydrocarbons. So the SRU is only as good as what it receives for feed streams. Reaction furnace temperature is typically directly proportional to the H2S content in the feed stream. So that illustrates the importance of the amine and SWS units. SRE can test these upstream units as well, optimizing for higher H2S contents and CO2 slip, and minimizing hydrocarbon pickup. In refineries, the sour water stripper sends a mixture of typically one-third H2S, one-third water, and one-third ammonia to the SRU. If the ammonia is not fully destroyed in the reaction furnace, residuals can carry over to the condensers and converters, risking the formation of ammonia salts. These salts negatively impact heat transfer and recovery efficiency, and like most SRU issues, you typically won't know it's there until it's too late. So we strive to achieve less than 150 ppm of ammonia downstream of the RF. And to do this, we actually need a temperature of 1150 degrees Celsius to fully destroy it. So optimizing the reaction furnace. SRE can conduct an amine survey to minimize hydrocarbon and BTEX contents in the acid gas. And with that survey, CO2 slip and H2S pickup can also be maximized. This can lead to optimizing the feed stream temperature to further maximize the initial conversion rates. The SRU is only as good as what it receives and how steady those feed streams are. This is why swings in flow and composition must be minimized, and when they do occur, the equipment and operators have to be ready to handle them. Based on SRE's testing experience, combustion air flow rates are always off by at least 10 to 20%. While this is normal, it's important that these error rates are not heightened. When calibrating analyzers like the tail gas analyzer, it's important that proper calibration gases are used, which represent the typical range for normal operations. And all cal gases should be not expired. Our tests have shown that the installation of a high-efficiency mixing burner can add over 100 degrees Celsius to the potential reaction furnace temperature. For refineries, when H2S qualities are low, a front-side split configuration is often best. It's important to optimize this setup with the proper flow fractions and to minimize the amount of air and nitrogen added to the system. This split flow setup requires that one-third of the total H2S be burned in order to have that 2-to-1 ratio of H2S to SO2 at the first converter.